In this Canva Pro tutorial, I'm gonna show you some super easy hacks to make insanely good thumbnails. Let's go. Most small YouTubers have some major struggles in trying to grow their channels. One of these major areas of struggle is in trying to create excellent thumbnails. Thumbnails that will entice the viewer to click and watch your video. I'm gonna show you some incredibly easy to use hacks that are gonna take your thumbnails from looking like this to this. The first thing you need to do is head to canva.com. Click on the top right corner where it says Create Account. Now, once you've created your account, you have the option of upgrading to Canva Pro. I'd highly recommend that you get the Pro version because it comes with all of the features unlocked that are missing from that free version. And this is going to give you a lot more power in creating excellent thumbnails. However, it's not absolutely necessary, and you can still make excellent thumbnails with some workarounds that you can find on the internet. But for a smooth and easy to design process, I prefer the Pro version. Trust me, you won't regret it. Next, now that you've got your Pro account ready to go, your homepage will look exactly like this. In the top right, you can click on either Create a Design or Custom Size. Custom size is great if you know the exact dimensions of what you want to create. For YouTube thumbnails, the standard size is 1280 by 720. Create a Design will let you search for or type in exactly what you want to make. Next, select YouTube Thumbnail, which brings you to this screen with a blank canvas. Here, you'll be able to choose any style of background or color scheme that you want. You have many options from solid colors to pastel and gradient backgrounds to using your very own photos if you prefer. In this tutorial, I'm going to choose green. Now, this is where the magic really starts to take place. Pay attention to what I'm about to show you, because these options you're going to use are going to take your basic and average looking thumbnails to the next level. Now that you've chosen your background, it's time to define what you want your thumbnail to look like. Your thumbnail should be consistent with your branding and style. Make sure that your design also expresses your personality and style. It will help you a lot once your channel grows much larger. Add some photos of yourself in different poses using this option right here. Click on Upload and then select the file you have saved on your computer. Once uploaded, you can then click on the photo to add it to your background. This is where it comes in super handy having a Pro account, because it comes with one of the best tools on the entire site, the Background Remover. Select Remove Background, and in a few moments, this is what you have. The next step is to resize your image. I suggest that if you're adding yourself to the thumbnail, you should almost always put yourself on the right side of the thumbnail, because when it appears on YouTube, the timestamp is on that side. I see a lot of people making the mistake of putting their font there instead, and then the timestamp covers it up. Next, once you've got your photo size changed, click on your image and hit Ctrl+C to copy, and then Ctrl+V to paste. Make the image slightly larger than the other one and select Position. Click on Backwards until it's behind the original image. Next, select Effect and then select Duotone. Choose a color that matches your color theme in the thumbnail. Next, select Adjust and put Blur all the way to the top. You've now got a super glowing and morph-like effect that you can place behind yourself or anywhere else in the thumbnail that you want to. Adjust the brightness, contrast, and saturation. This will allow you to get different color effects and combinations. Test things out to see what you can come up with. Choose a neat looking separator to put between yourself and the text in your thumbnail. It really makes everything stand out much better. Next, add your font. Click on Text, Add a Heading, and then select a font style that fits your branding and style. There are hundreds of fonts to choose from, so search until you find the perfect fit. Once you've chosen your font, select the text box and type in the words that you're using in the thumbnail. I always put one word per box so that you can easily move the text around in the thumbnail and place things where you want them to go. Next, select the word and click on Effects. Then click on Shadow and put Transparency all the way to the top. Then select your letter outline color. I find that black tends to work very well with most colors and styles, but you can try out all kinds of combinations until you find a color that you like for that thumbnail. Next, select the word and hit Ctrl+C to copy, and then Ctrl+V to paste. With the duplicate word, again select Effects. This time, simply move Blur all the way to the top. You've now created a glowing effect for your letters. Layer this on top of the original word. Then select the top layer and copy and paste it 4 more times for a total of 5 layers on top. You now end up with a word that looks amazing. Repeat this process for every word in your thumbnail, and then place the font nicely in your thumbnail, making sure to space things out evenly between your words and your photos or your icons that you use in the thumbnail. If you have a lot of empty space, simply fill it in by copying glowing effects and spacing them around the thumbnail. You can also add arrows, characters, or other neat items in to give it a branded look and style for your thumbnail and your channel. You now know how to make insanely good looking thumbnails that are going to get your click-through rate climbing in no time. And this is going to directly impact your channel growth. Now I'd love to know your thoughts on this topic, so be sure to drop a comment below and leave your feedback. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.